हेलो, टुडे आवर टॉपिक इज रेजिस्टेंस वेल्डिंग एंड टाइप्स। ओके, वी ऑल आर एक्वेंटेड विथ वेल्डिंग सिस्टम बिकॉज वी ऑल आर सी इन मार्केट प्लेस और रोड साइड देयर इज ए वेल्डिंग शॉप। बट रादर देन दैट वेल्डिंग शॉप, वी आर हियर डिस्कशन अबाउट रेजिस्टेंस वेल्डिंग। देन व्हाट आर द डिफरेंस बिटवीन एन इलेक्ट्रिकल वेल्डिंग एंड as compared to that traditional welding, whatever you saw. Next one is our outlooks. What are the outlooks we cover today? Introduction, basic principles, types of welding, resistance welding, different method of resistance welding, application and use, drawbacks and conclusion. Next is, then what is a welding? The welding is the process of joining two similar or dissimilar materials with filler material at high temperature. Means we need a high temperature for melting two similar or dissimilar materials. For that purpose, we want to a filler material. Okay, as you saw in traditional welding machine, but here in these two figure there is no filler material. Means this is some new technology welding machine, that is electrical welding machine. That electrical heating or electrical welding is classified as based upon a formula, that is H equal to I square RT. Then what is H, what is I, R and T? That is main factor is we need heat, as like in traditional welding machine. Here also we need heat. That heat will collect from current. Okay, according to current increases, the heat will increases. Then two more factor are here considerable. That considering factor is resistance and time. Okay, so that we conclude that we require temperature. For requirement of temperature, we need current. Okay, so we are discussing about resistance heating, resistance welding. That resistance heating transfer to welding in which method? In resistance welding method. That resistance welding means we have certain arrangement that we need current, maximum current, so that our metal should be melt and joined. Okay, for that reason we need a transformer. That transformer is in step down condition. Okay, that step down means, as we know that a transformer can only transfer power from one side to another. Here also we are using this type of transformer, but in this transformer you can visualize it. You can see that transformer is step down in condition, means power is same in primary and secondary, power is same, but voltage is very low in this secondary, in this transformer. That is known as step down transformer. In secondary side voltage is very low. Clear? And why this type of arrangement or this type of transformer we are using in this resistance welding? Because we need maximum current. Clear? For that reason, we have to decreasing the voltage in secondary side. Okay, we are placing here two electrodes, and one is movable electrode and one is fixed arm electrode. Clear? And next one is our metal which we want to welding, that two similar or dissimilar metal. Here we are considering about similar metal. Clear? And why we adopt this resistance welding or electrical welding? Because it gives up some new feature as compared to our traditional welding. What are the key main three features? First one is no need to use any plugs or filler material. Means we don't any required filler material, as like you saw in welding machine in market or any shop. Okay. Next one is multiple sheets joined together at the same time. Clear. And next one is save production cost. This is a very vital role. That is, the cost is very minimized. Then what are the resistance welding methods and what are the types, so that this we know the resistance welding working in this principle, but how that how factor is means different method of resistance welding. What are the different method? Why we cover that different method? We already know that the resistance welding working in this principle. Then why we need different method? You can see in this two figure that is totally different work as per our requirement, so that we are also designing a special type of instrument for our requirement, for our requirement of welding metals. Okay. So what are the total difference, or what are the categories list of resistance welding? This is the total electrical welding categorized by two types. That is, one is resistance welding and one is arc welding. That resistance welding also categorized in four types, that is spot, seam, projection, butt welding. Also butt welding classify as two different types. Okay. And next one is arc welding. Arc welding also classified as four types, that is heatal arc welding, carbon arc welding, atomic hydrogen arc welding, and helium or argon arc welding. Okay, then we have to consider about resistance welding. That is, one first part is our spot welding. Clear. Then what are the key feature of spot welding? That spot welding is defined as in this left side figure, you can see a step down transformer is connected. That transformer delivers maximum current in secondary winding. That's why that current will moving towards the metal which we want to welding. Clear? On the peak point, the current is very high. That's why the metal to metal will be connected according to current flow and heat will maximum. Clear. And in our slide, in right side of figure, one man is operating a spot welding, and you can visualize also, you can see also, one is fixed and another is moving electrode. That up and down are shown in figure, and one is X switch is connected in pedal switch, that is for usable purposes, that will help to ensure, or that will easy for operation. And in which place we can use this, or we can use the spot welding concept in this area, that is in automobile sector, lots of robots are working. As you saw in Discovery or movie, or practically you may saw in practical field, clear. And without spot welding, it will be also happen. It will not a difficult one, or you can make any type of vehicle. But by using spot welding, you can product maximum amount of product. That means maximum amount of car or bike. Okay, by the help of spot welding. And another is in my left slide, you can see that is a lithium ion cell. Clear? Lithium ion cell are connected in by the help of a nickel strip, and you cannot solder, or you cannot give maximum temperature to that nickel strip or lithium ion cell, because if maximum heat will provide that cell will damage or maybe explode. That's why you need to a certain amount of current, and that current is likely to be sustainable to the or lithium cell, and that welding is performed by the help of spot welding method. Okay, next welding is seam welding. Then what are the difference between main difference between seam welding and spot welding? That is, main difference is here we are using rolling wheel electrodes, means our electrode in moving condition. Clear? And next one is, in seam welding we just put a electrode that is in rotating in nature, and we just weld that material with a series spot welding, means we spot welded in a series manner, is called as seam welding. Clear? Here also we are using a step down transformer, it is basic. And next one is, in our right figure in my slide, you can see that is two electrode in rotating manner, and workpiece is the situated as per your figure, you can see, and one is water tube is there. For that, maximum heat can be absorbed by the water flow. Clear? And this seam welding also we are using in different manner or different area. That area is makes a lots of product. That product is basically rolling pipes, okay, or you can make a different utensils or any type of structure, whatever you want. Also this seam welding also used for nuclear reactor protector. Clear? And in our slide, that is a example of a seam welding machine. Also that DIX will show you that DIX is two electrode that is in rotating condition, that is a moving electrode. Clear? Next welding is projection welding. That is, projection means when we want some accuracy, 100% accuracy, 99% accuracy, means we have to ensure that our accuracy should be maintained. For that reason, we designed a specific type of welding machine, that is projection welding machine, that will give our 100% accuracy and highly mechanical strength. Just like, for example, a bolt or any type of bolt, nut and bolt arrangement. That bolt also contain a threading part or also a tightening part. Clear? For that reason, we cannot use in that place a spot welding, because inside will be absent, inside welding will be absent. So that we are here a projection welding method, we decide a projection. Clear? That projection will be melting projected part, as you saw in this figure. Clear? And also we are providing a force. Clear? The force and current supply to the electrode are simultaneously. After that we get a specific product or final product, so that our welding will be performed. For example, here we are using lots of bolts. Clear? And lots of highly mechanical strength absorbing capacity material, so that our mechanical strength will be maximum. So for that reason we need a projection welding. Clear? And next one is bot welding. Bot welding is the very interesting welding, that is divided in three types. Okay, that is offset bot welding, flash bot welding, and percussion bot welding. Clear? Let's discuss about offset bot welding. Offset bot welding is a similar or very simple welding. That is, already the electrode, the welding metal parts are already joined. Clear? We already joined that metal. After that we give some supply. Clear? That supply will give high amount of current. That high amount of current will deliver maximum temperature. That maximum temperature will occur in the welding part, welding two welding part gap that temperature will rise in that gap. Clear? As you saw in right side of figure, upper figure, you can visualize that the two metal is connected. Clear? Already connected, and supply is given to transformers, step down transformer. After that, the current will rise. That current will rise. After that, the metal is, after final our completion of project, our final product will, you can see in below figure. Clear? Offset butt welding also join maximum, also we are using in different sector in the industry. Also we are joining local workshop also. Clear? And next one is our flash butt welding. So what are the difference between flash butt welding and offset butt welding? Here offset butt welding, we are already connected that two metal. After that we giving supply. But in here flash butt welding, we are already connected two metal. Gradually we make a distance so that a arc will formation. Clear? After arc will formation, that metal is highly gaining temperature. That highly temperature cause melting of that metal. Clear? Are on this flash butt welding also used for jointing our train line. Clear? And next one is percussion butt welding. Percussion butt welding is the very interesting butt welding. This type of welding is basically used in electronics equipment. So that here we are using a step down transformer which consists of a rectifier section. That rectifier section provide DC voltage output. That DC voltage output is connected with a main capacitor. That main capacitor consists of a two-way switch. That S is connected, S can be connected in A and connected in B. So initially what we did, S is connected with A. When S is connected with A, the main capacitor is charged. After that, what we'll do, that metal pieces to be weld, that metal are closer to each other. After that, we switch on in S to connect to B. So that a highly voltage will discharge from that capacitor and that two metal is gradually joined as per this figure. Clear? In the upper figure, this is the process and this is the output. So what is the benefit of percussion butt welding? The timing is very important for the electronics equipment because we need a temperature, you need a high temperature, but if high temperature goes a long time interval, it will damage our product. So that timing factor should be less. That means this type of arrangement will give us a very little time, that is 0.1 second. Clear? So that we arrange this type of welding method. Okay, next one is, what are the drawbacks? Every new things or every things having some drawbacks. Clear? The drawback is high equipment cost is very high, thickness of work piece is limited due to current requirement. Clear? Current requirement is very high. It is the main thing and it is the needed. Without current, we cannot produce electricity or we cannot produce temperature, as much of temperature, so that we can make a welding. Clear? And next one is, it is less efficient or high conductive material. High conductive material. Next one is, high electric power required. Clear? And next one is, conclusion. And conclusion is, we can minimize the drawback by research and developing with the adopting new technology, such as how to developing maximum current with existing power. If we develop this concept, how to develop maximum current with existing power, then this adapt this technology, this resistance welding is highly popular, will be highly popular in current future, and it's also going on. Okay, thank you.